The Libre Initiative, the nonprofit, nonpartisan organization that I work for, is founded and based its mission on the simple and undeniable truth of that statement. We believe that all people want to be free, and specifically focus on educating and spreading the message of economic freedom to the U.S. Hispanic community. We believe that people naturally yearn for independence and the ability to succeed on their own without bureaucrats interfering and making decisions for them. I stand here before you tonight and I assert that the Hispanic community naturally belongs in the liberty movement. I truly believe that Hispanics will yet be some of the greatest proponents of liberty that this country has ever seen. When I see my fellow Latinos, I see people who struggle for, and to this day, who still gravitate towards freedom. But perhaps I'm a little biased. You see, I grew up with the love of freedom in my blood. My mother's family is mostly Czech and Slovak, and we labored under communism for quite some time. They came to America in search of a better life. And, well, my father is from Puerto Rico. A lot of people who've never been to Puerto Rico probably think it's, you know, just like any other place in the United States, except for salsa limited. But it's not. Even to this day, when I go to visit family, there's no hot water. It makes taking a shower really unpleasant. In any case, my grandmother, mi abuelita, Esther Arroyo, she came from Puerto Rico with her then 3 kids in tow, not speaking a lick of English. She settled in central Pennsylvania and took a job at a peach canning factory. My grandmother worked 3 factory jobs just to put food on the table for her 5 kids. 1 was in the peach canning factory and 2 were in the sewing factory. She learned broken English on the peach canning factory line from an Italian woman. Italian was closer to Spanish than English, so they would work every day on new words. She recalls that those days were long, tiring, and particularly cold. But what strikes me about so beautiful is that whenever she recounts her story, she's not complaining. She didn't say that anybody owed her anything. She wasn't searching for government programs. She was thankful for those jobs. They didn't exist in Puerto Rico. You see, she grew up in a large family in rural Puerto Rico, usually going without food, almost never having shoes. And they often ate what they could find, maybe a mango here, bartering for a chicken there. She had to leave school after 4th grade and work in the factories just to help feed her siblings. She had to lie when she was 9 years old and tell them that she was 15 so that she could get a job for 12 hours a day sewing. When I asked her why she came to the state, especially when she talks about Puerto Rico so fondly, she looked at me like I was crazy and stated as if it were the most obvious thing in the world. I came here for a job. I came here for opportunity. For a better life. You see, in Puerto Rico, there's a culture of big government and government dependency, which has led to a poor economy. Only recently have pro-growth economic reforms been seen. For example, with Governor Fortunio, the first thing he did in office was immediately cut government spending by 20%. Doesn't seem like a lot for the liberty movement, but for Puerto Rico, it was massive. One fact I find astonishing is that in Puerto Rico, if you wanted to start a job, start a business, there were 28 different permits and procedures that you had to go through. Now, they've reformed that, so it's one process, one permit, that you can just process online. Reforms like that make it easier to start the businesses which drive our economy, especially in diverse communities where you see small businesses starting up more rapidly. Even now, after sharing that personal story with you, it amazes me that I'm standing here right now. Within 2 generations, my family has gone from basically illiterate, my grandmother still can't read and write the English very well, to graduating college, being the first person in my family to do so. But that's what America looks like in just about every jeopardy for millions of Americans, especially in the Latino community. Economic freedom is slipping through our fingers, and with it are going jobs and opportunities. While national unemployment has been at more than 8% for more than 45 months, Hispanic unemployment has been between 10% and 11% nationally, in some areas as high as 14% and 15%. The unemployment number for Hispanic youth in my age bracket, from 16 to 24, has been around 21% nationally. More than 6 million Hispanic children live in poverty, marking the first time in American history that a minority group surpasses the majority group for having the most people in poverty. Those are numbers that we cannot accept for anyone in this country, especially when we, all of us in this room, know the solution to the problem. The answer to our current economic woes is not more government. It is less regulation, less government, free trade, a sound money supply, and more opportunities for everyone.
Turn it into activism.
liberty, and limited government. We need to share that message. As una comunidad, as a community, and more importantly, as a country, we must vigilantly fight for liberty and protect what made America great in the first place, for offering us jobs, opportunities,